Hey YouTube, what's up? Hope you all are doing well. So today I'm going to solve another lab from Web Security Academy that belongs to the server-side topic directory traversal. And this is going to be the lab number 5. And in this lab, we will see some user input validation and a different approach of the code from the developer side. So before going to this lab or before going to solve this lab, this warning is always for you. So this video and its contents are only for educational purpose and I do not support any unethical or illegal act. So that being said, let's go to the lab and see what we have to do today. So this is lab number 5, file path traversal and validation of a start of path. So suppose developer say, okay, the user input must start from /where/www/x/y/z. So the agenda is, this lab contains a file path traversal vulnerability in the display of product image, and the application transmits the full file path via request parameter. So this time, before the parameter value, suppose that file name, and file name is equal to 1.jpg or 1.png. We saw something like that, but this time that parameter will have the complete path of that image file and validates that the supplied path start with the expected folder, means /where. So to solve the lab, retrieve the contents of the etc file. That's good. Let's go to the lab. The image is not opening, so let's try something else or the same. I don't know why today the port switcher site is not working fine, but my internet is good. So we come to that and let's go and view the image. But before that, I already opened up the burp suite, so I'm going to just enable the burp suite on my browser. So okay, then go to view the image, and as you can see, we come to view the image. So this is going to be your parameter, and the parameter value is this time you get the whole path instead of just getting the file name. You get the whole path. So /where/www/images, and this is the image name. So this time what developer did, that the path must start from where, something like this he did. So, and we got the whole path. So let's see, we can try something ABC instead of where, and let's see if we get it or not. And of course, as expected, missing parameter file name. So although we have the file name, but we will get something like this. Next, if we try where, because as you can see, where, www and images, it means most chances for this web server is Linux, right? Because this directory structure belongs to the Linux machine, and inside Linux, the file names and the folder names, directory names, all these are case sensitive. So if you try to bypass this by just making a small letter or capital letter, uppercase or lowercase, that's not gonna work, because it needs the exact case sensitive value, right? So go back here on the burp suite, come here, and that was the first request. Okay, so we can send this to the repeater. Go to the repeater. Okay, and instead of this image, what we can try is, okay, because the developer approach was to validate the input, and the starting value must be /where. So okay, /where, let it same as it is, but we can control that value from here. So from this we come out from the images, and from the second value we go to the www, and from this we go to the where, and then in the slash. So etc /passwd and hit send. And yeah, we got the content of etc passwd file. So now if you go back, you will find that you already solved the lab. Come on. Yeah. So congratulations, you solved the lab. So thank you very much for watching this video. If you feel this content is valuable for you, please like, subscribe and share as much as you can. And one more important thing, after finishing this module, I will also try to explain how you can mitigate this vulnerability while you are coding for your web application. See you in the next video. Bye.